the status of quarterback Drew Willey, head coach Mike O'Shea with our foreign lology.
Mike, bad news, Drew Willey not coming back. Can you give us an update on him and what we can expect in the second half here?
Yeah, he hurt upper body injury, so he won't be back. But Brian and Robert, I mean, we got a lot of faith in him. That's what they signed up for, to come in and win games for us.
A lot of talk about BC trying to run the ball in this game, but really it's been Kevin Glenn, 14 to 15, almost 200 yards. How do you disrupt him?
Well, I mean, we got to believe in our blitz and keep coming after him. I mean, when we execute at a high level, we got some sacks. We're just going to keep doing that.
Thanks, Michael.
Thanks.
Winnipeg had six sacks in the first inning, but now it'll be up to Brian Braum. We mentioned with Hamilton last year, a former second-round pick of the Green Bay Packers, spent some time with the Buffalo Bills as well.
Yeah, Gordon, he's not wet behind the ears. He just has very limited experience in a Canadian Football League game. And he's going to have some tough sledding behind here up against the number one pass defense in the league, and certainly the number one defense in the league as far as net yards are concerned. And BC is playing with the lead, and Kevin Glenn is hot. He's very patient against the Winnipeg Blitz, and Brian Braum and the Winnipeg Blue Bomber offense has got their work cut out for him.
Tim Brown takes the second half kickoff from the 15-yard line, and Brown dives up to the 35-yard line. Stop the play by Don Anamba. And a flag comes down near the end of that play. Dan West was involved with one of the BC Lions. There were five unnecessary roughness penalties called against Winnipeg in last week's game.
Unnecessary roughness, Winnipeg number 33, 15-yard penalty, first down.
So tack on 15 at the end of that, and the Lions will start at their own 50.
Yeah, this is not good. I know he's getting roughed up by a couple guys.
I don't see it.
He did come across with the right hook over the top to the helmet, but I don't think it was anything behind it.
On first down, Glenn throws with a pass incomplete for S.J. Hedera. A fastball over the middle. And Hedera had trouble hanging on. Kevin Glenn hasn't had many incompletions in the football game. That is just his second after going 14 for 15 in the opening half.
That right there was sneaky by Kevin Glenn. I'm talking about 14 to 15. Winnipeg's been good against the run. Their Achilles heel, but Glenn has been really solid under pressure today.
Now Glenn throws to Arsenal, who gets wrapped up right away and thrown down by Winnipeg safety Maurice Leggett, who's back in the football game after being shaken up in the first half. It rings up third down for the Lions, who have won four of their last five, while the Bombers have lost four of their last five. Now, that's a lot of losses to Saskatchewan in that string.
And you talk to Mike O'Shea about those losses, and he doesn't really see them as losses to Saskatchewan. They're just losses. And but it's against a divisional opponent, and
you're our rival.
Schmidt is just pounding the football tonight. Schindemeyer takes that at the 9-yard line and does a good job to get five. A late flag comes down as he goes out of bounds at the 14-yard line.
Another nice punt by Ricky Schmidt.
And another penalty against the Bombers. It's going to move them back.
That's just insult to injury.
During the return, illegal block. Winnipeg number 13. At the distance, the goal. First down.
So Anamba gets called, and Brian Braum's first full possession of the season will start at his own 7-yard line. He's thrown one pass this year. It was in week one against Toronto.
Yeah, this is Don Anamba. That's the block. I don't see it. Penalty was called. Back Winnipeg up. Brian Braum, even more precarious situation.
So from his end zone, Braum under pressure throws the pass incomplete. Looking for Fitzgerald up the sideline and being covered there by Josh Johnson. The flag comes down. It'll be a first down for the Bombers as fullback Carl Fitzgerald, who has four catches on the year.
That's unfair.
Or rather, one catch
Houston
of the year.
Number 23. Automatic first down at the point of foul.
Yeah, the fans here don't like it, but it's pretty clear from our spot up here in the booth. Look at that. Right there, you see the hand clearly tugging on his shoulder, impeding the receiver from getting downfield. Then he walks up on his leg and tangles up with Fitzgerald. That's a pretty easy call when you got a hold of the jersey like that.
14-yard penalty, first down line, or Bobbers, rather, at the 25-yard line. And now Denmark makes the catch and picks up a couple on the play. Let's take it back to the first half and the injury to Drew Willis.
Scrambling, Brandon Smith comes over the top, all his weight's on that right shoulder. Drew Willie is not coming back, and it's the Brian Brom show now. Against the number one pass defense in the league.
At home.
Backed up in their own end.
Second and long. Brom throws, and the pass is caught by Rory Kohler. And Kohler gets to the 25-yard line, but well short. Winnipeg first down, and Saul Elamimian with five first half tackles going to make the stop there.
Yeah, and Torrey Williams and Solomon Elamimian helping out. You know, it's just solid defense. Everybody in the league understands that. Everybody does it. They play off, let them take the underneath, rally the football, deliver the lick, get the man down, and force the punt.
And now Haralahu stands back. Fitzgerald to snap it. Well, the last one sailed over his head. That was good. And Haralahu gets a very good punt away to Brown at the 35-yard line. And Brown gets dropped where he stood as Fitzgerald, the long snapper, was down to make the tackle. 15-3, the Lions lead on the CFL on TSN from Vancouver. Speak about how well the Lions could run against Winnipeg. Here's Brian Lalge with more.
Yeah, Gordon, it wasn't a guarantee, as Dennis Stolsky's behind me. He, of course, made that guarantee a couple of weeks ago against Saskatchewan. But Harris, more than anything, wanted to provide some motivation for his team. He said it was a goal and a belief that if that offensive line played more physical and tried to dictate play, they could get something done. One of the reasons he believed was the return of Jamarcus Hardrick to that offensive line. He brought a real physical edge to it. But he also wanted to send a message to coaches. They need to believe in the running game. Just 25 yards on 14 carries for Harris in the last two games, including an awful weather game. He wants the coaches to commit to pounding the ball inside. Hasn't happened so far. Just 8 carries for 30 yards as a team in that first half, guys.
And a gain there of 7 up to the 45-yard line.
And that's more of a product of the mindset of the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, stacking the line of scrimmage and doing a nice job. But what they haven't accounted for is Kevin Glenn's experience and certainly savvy play of beating the blitz and getting big chunks. Very stealth-like in the first half.
And the former bomber gets dropped by Teague Sherman. The ball comes out. And who's got it? And Andre Prue indicates that Glenn was somehow able to recover the football. After being piled on by a host of bombers, Teague Sherman was the first man there, and Kevin Glenn slowly gets back to his feet.
Yeah, and this is more pressure we saw in the first half. You heard Mike O'Shea say it. Here's going to be the pressure here by Teague Sherman, second-year player from Manitoba, virtually untouched. And BC's lucky that Glenn didn't get hurt on the play. Now he's trying to get the ball below his legs, and that's got to be a very awkward situation to be in,
to say the least. Schmidt, a low tumbling kick. And Studemeier from the 28-yard line gets the corner. Here comes Studemeier looking for a block. He gets it. Across midfield he goes and out of bounds at the BC 50-yard line. A flag comes down. Two come down after he went out of bounds. On the other side of the field, the return is 32 yards. As Troy Studemeier gets around the corner. And here's the call from Andre Prue.
I think Andre's getting tired. At the end of the play, major foul, face mask,
BC number 27. 15-yard penalty enforced from the end of the play. Automatic first down.
J.R. LaRose gets called for the face mask. And so the Bombers will have the ball at the BC 35-yard line. But we return to Vancouver right after this. Starting Loyola Davis, Thursday, starting September 25th on CTV. So with the penalty, the Bombers have the ball first down at the BC 35-yard line. And Brian Braum at the control. He gives the ball off to Nick Grigsby. Grigsby has not been a major factor in this football game tonight.
Wasn't in week five when he played the Lions. 15 carries, 19 yards, averaged 1.3 yards a carry.
And 6 for 19 tonight.
Are going to get her done. Putting your young quarterback, inexperienced quarterback, I should say, Brian Braum, the second long situation, with the best pass defense in the league.
Braum, a 28-year-old native of Louisville, Kentucky, where he played his college football.
Comes from the football family. Basically owns Kentucky and Louisville.
Down, Braum throws with the pass field over the head of Aaron Kelly. And that'll bring up third down and a field goal try now for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers.
BC Lions brought a little pressure from the short side of the football field. Pressure the young quarterback to get the football out of his hand. And Big Hill gets there a little late, but certainly forced the issue. I like the game plan. Pressure. They can see it fast, because with quarterbacks who don't have experience, the game's not unfolding quickly for them. It takes time to visualize everything and see it. The game's happening too fast.
There, Marlowe hits the 42-yard line. He's hit the upright twice this year. Puts this one through, and the Winnipeg Blue Bombers now have 6 on the season, on the night, rather. A 9-point lead to the BC Lions. Kevin Webb goes back to work. When we come back to Vancouver after this. Ken Parker, the son of legendary Rush and James. Pick Parker on the left, and there's his poster. Quick and slick. Look at you. Is that back when you were moonlighting as a Chippendale dancer?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
Look at the flow too. That's a good flow.
Hey, look at. Hey, I'm telling you, quick and slick. That picture was taken in '91. So, see, it was what, 2 years old at the time. I bet you. Quick's got it.
You know what? The flow's gone, huh? The flow is gone.
I was thinking about letting it back when Mark Neely airs me off the boss. He won't let me roll my wing out again like that. I'd bring it back, right? It'd be fine. I'd look like Mike Riley's dad.
All business at the front, all party at the back. Hey, Matty?
That's it.
Flashback.
All right, yeah, thanks, Katie. The flashback. I know where you live.
Here's a direct snap now to Stephon Logan. And Logan around the corner to put it down and more out of bounds. In the Winnipeg territory, and a first down to the 52-yard line.
They're trying to get this going, flatten them out with all the... Basically, you've got 7 offensive linemen trying to combat what Winnipeg's doing, bringing everybody into the box. They're trying to make that box bigger, create some holes and some seams. Find a little bit there.
On first down, Glass throws and Logan gets cut down right away. That's a great defensive play by the corner, Chris Randall.
Randall, I think he's an underrated player. I like the way this kid plays week in, week out, on special teams as well. This kid flies around and makes it happen. In fact, I don't think the ball comes his way too often because he is a lockdown corner in just his first year with the Winnipeg Blue Bombers.
He's got an interception for a touchdown this year. The Bombers, in fact, have 4 defensive touchdowns this season. That's been a big story this year. 22 defensive touchdowns scored so far. That's more than all of last season. Every team's got at least one. Now Glenn steps up. And throws. The pass complete. Andrew Harris got a first down. At the 36-yard line.
to go to a receiver running up the seam here. You can look at him with his eyes on his right. He's really staring it down hard. He wants to go in this direction. He gives it as much time as possible, steps up in the pocket, and then just darts one to Harris. Moving the chains.
Now the give to Harris again, and gets wrapped up right away. So here's the thought, Matt. With Kevin Glenn at the controls, you've got a veteran quarterback for BC. The Lions have won in Saskatchewan this year. They've won in Calgary.
Yep.
They're 6-4 on the year. They're a great second-half team, have been
yep.
for the last few years. They're the Grey Cup host team. Are they the dark horse in the West?
I think that's a good description for them. I think they're a very talented football team in the West, and certainly have all the parts. Without Travis Lule, they're in good stead with certainly Kevin Glenn. They're one play away from John Beck, much like we're looking at the Brian Brown right now.
Randall almost picked that off and go back the other way and bring up third down.
You're looking at Tino Sinceri and Saskatchewan behind Darian Durant, very wet behind the ears. And the team that is in the best position is, of course, Drew Tate and the Calgary Stampeders. When Bo Levi went down today, you've got a guy who's been there, done that. And you're not going to miss a beat with Drew Tate in there. And BC is very fortunate to have Kevin Glenn at the helm because he certainly gives them every possibility of being effective offensively. You can see it here in the first half. You look at those numbers, 18 to 20, well over 200 yards, being smart with the football, taking sacks, not giving up field, I mean, not making silly decisions. Kevin Glenn has got the right ingredients to take the BC Lions where they want to go this year, and that's quite possibly Gord being the fourth team to host the Grey Cup and win.
The streak is over for Paul McCallum, and moving up the sidelines for the Bombers is Devon Washington, who tightrope up the sidelines, was out of bounds at about the 10-yard line. So McCallum with his first miss since July the 12th, he remains 15-6. Close the sidelines. Here's Brian Lawson.
Yeah, Gordy's out with an eye injury. Apparently he took a finger in the eye, and the retina or the cornea is scratched. Also a bit of swelling there, so he's not going to return. Abraham Kroma now goes in the middle. As for the BC Lions, Courtney Taylor, negative on the x-rays for his foot. It's a foot sprain. He's available for return if needed, if there's an emergency, but at this point they hope he does not have to go back in the game, guys.
So Kowalee, who hadn't played middle linebacker in the CFL since 2011, we played that position for the Toronto Argonauts, but Michael O'Shea was there as an assistant coach. Comes out again on the injury, just pile up down for the Bomber D.
Yeah, I got to think that the doctor stepped in there and got in the way of the player there, because Israel Kowalee's got a love and obsession for this game. Really second to none. Yeah, I think he played with far worse than that, but that's got to be a doctor's decision there. It's a serious eye injury for him to be out of the corner.
Bombers backed up again. They start their own 10-yard line. And play called before the ball is snapped, and Robbie Bryant was well into the backfield before the ball had been moved back to Bronx.
As a scoring play, the previous play is under review.
Now, this is interesting.
As a scoring play, the previous play is under review by the command center.
Devon Washington appeared to go out of bounds. It looked to me like Washington stepped out of bounds in the end zone when he picked up that missed field goal. So the command center is looking at this to see if Washington did go out. It would be another point for the BC Lions.
And we're going to get a look at it right here.
Yeah, he's up.
Right there. That's a pretty tight angle. 74 is right on it. Command center's going to be looking at what you're looking at. He went a long way to bring it out to the 10-yard line. There's the spot again right there.
Is it conclusive to overturn it? We've been... He's correct in our assessment before.
Yes, we have, Gordon.
Several times. Although, I maintain we were right last week. But let bygones be bygones in the Montreal game.
Well, I know the coaches talk to Glenn Johnson and the officials throughout the week and certainly file their complaints and what they see, and they get feedback. And often what we're hearing is some apologies from CFL offices and some missed calls that happened. But they just want to
get this. By the way, the last.
That looks out to me right there.
This is not a coach's challenge, but the last 14 coach's challenges in the CFL have been unsuccessful.
Yes. So, as coaches are kind of shaking their heads. That should be good enough right there.
So, if you're Winnipeg, though, did you want Washington to bring it out anyway?
It looked like design. It looked like he's trying to get the corners. Design called play. We want to keep a 9-point lead as opposed to giving up a single there and making it a one-score game, convert for two. I can see that happening, but so early, I'd give a single and get field position the way this game's played out. Certainly with the young quarterback. After review, the ball carrier did step out of bounds, in goal. Therefore, single point on the play. Winnipeg will have the football on the 35-yard line and a first down.
Michael O'Shea said perfect in response to the call. So actually, O'Shea seemed pleased with that development.
Yeah, he'd much rather have that. Field position. Inexperienced quarterback, Brown is getting his feet wet here.
So it's a 10-point lead now for the Lions.
Correction on the play. The field goal attempt occurred from the 38-yard line. Ball will be placed on the 38-yard line and a first down.
There we go.
Three more yards. That's all cleared up.
Let's see, it's a 10-point game now. My math was all messed up there, Gord. I don't know what I was
doing. Who was going to check?
Hey. Well, maybe come over here.
You are over here. What are you talking about? Kick in the great tree. Braum wants to go over the top, but throws, and the pass is cut. As Kohler makes the grab up the 50-yard line. And good for a Winnipeg Blue Bomber first down as Kohler makes the catch.
I like a little play action. Freeze the linebackers. This is nice. Point fake. Nice pocket. Step up in it. Plenty of room. Throw a strike. Rory Kohler. Don't tell you down. Get you some confidence in a hurry.
Preview of the first down. Carey crosses midfield to the BC territory at the 53-yard line.
Yeah, we have pictures that we're privy to during halftime. And we saw Brian Braum in the locker room looking at his play call list on his wrist, frantically going over the, no doubt, hundreds of plays on his wrist, just making sure that everything was set in his brain. He's out there and execute like he's doing right now.
Braum completes that pass ahead to Denmark. Another first down up to the 45-yard line. Michael O'Shea, after the loss to Saskatchewan last week, gave his team a couple of days off to go home for a bit. Relax, let's reset and come back. But trying to regroup now with an inexperienced quarterback. He's lost 4-5.
Yeah, they're putting a nice drive together here.
Here's Rigby again. Throws it back to flea flicker, back to Braum. Flags are down. Braum just kind of hooks that away. Another flag comes down.
I understand what he's trying to do here, Gord.
I think they're going to call this intentional grounding.
Yeah, because the ball didn't cross the line of scrimmage. He's out of the pocket.
Be a massive loss for the Bombers.
Holding. Winnipeg number 39. That counts as a climb. Intentional grounding. Winnipeg number 12. Second down.
So from the 44-yard line, it's back to their own 54.
Because they tried some trickery. And if they felt like they had them where they wanted them, they threw the football. a good 40 yards down the field, got themselves in a good situation, a first and 10, and with the trickery off the run play action, tossed back to the quarterback, and
boxing out, it's a second and 20, run the Statue of Liberty.
Nothing extreme here.
Complete. Ford Fox is running with him step for step and brings up third down. Denmark has signed a contract extension this week with the Bombers.
You got to look at Brian Brom's arm there. I kind of like that. I like the aggressiveness. Why not? Just go ahead and push the big key. Try it. Air it out. Right in here. He's going straight up the football field. Brom's going to have protection. He's going to let her fly. Certainly Denmark can as well.
Oh, who's punt taken by Tim Brown. Flags are down as Brown fills the ball cleanly up the 11-yard line. And that'll be a no-yard penalty of the 15-yard variety against Winnipeg as Dan West got in there early.
We're calling his name for the wrong reason. Took one earlier.
No yards. Winnipeg number 23, 15-yard penalty. First down.
So the Lions get some breathing room here under 2 minutes to go in the third quarter.
I tell you, you know, playing these teams, man, is oftentimes you're an unsung hero. You're doing your job. You're flying down there, trying to create leverage. You get there just a little bit too early because of your hustle. Yeah, Dan knew it. He's a warrior on those teams who want to take blue balls.
Glenn Lawson over the top trying to find Sean Gore, but
that was a throwaway. And still took a shot. That's more pressure by the Bombers. You know, they haven't shot away. You heard Mike O'Shea, their head coach, talk about it at halftime at farhand. He says, we just got to believe in our blitz and get to them. And they're continuing to do more of the same. Kevin was up to the task in the first half, going 14 to 15.
Lions trying to even their home record at 3-3 on the year. They were 16-2 at home over the previous two seasons combined. Now Glenn swings and the pass is incomplete. Trying to find Gore on the other side. That'll bring up third down. And not much offensive production for the Lions here in the second half thus far.
That's tight coverage by Bruce Johnson, first-year player from Miami. He was with Gore the whole way. Again, pressure being applied by the Bombers. Glenn's got one-on-one. He's going to come and run a dig, and there's the first-year player from Miami, Bruce Johnson, all over it. Watch him break on this. He's breaking before the receiver. Gets his arm in there and strips it. It's a heck of a play.
Here with a low-driving kick. Taken by Studemeyer at the 45-yard line, and more flags fly on the return. Studemeyer got close to the 45-yard line on the return.
During the return, illegal block. Winnipeg number 52, taking a penalty, first down.
So again, the Bombers move back this time to their own 39-yard line. DC leading by 10. Bombers get the bye next week, the last team in the league to get a bye week. And now the pass incomplete the sideline. Brings up second down for the Bombers. So once again for Ryan Brom, a tall order against the BC defense.
Yeah, Gore, this is a situation where, you know, it's what you get paid to do. Talking about Shane's interview at halftime, and he addressed that as well. That's what these guys sign up for. Come out there and be pro quarterback.
Could be the final play of the third quarter. Sabres only down by 10 here at BC Plain. Here comes the rush. Brom stands in, but fails that pass over the Lions bench and out of bounds. It'll bring up third down. 16-6, the Lions lead. For the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, who have lost their starting quarterback, Drew Willie. And so once again, to emphasize to the BC Lions, in their last seven quarters of football, Matt, they've allowed 11 points.
A dominant defense, and Kevin Glenn understands the defense that he's working with. He's been with them. This is his 10th game now, and he's just going to manage the game here on out. It wasn't a very productive quarter for Kevin, only about 25 yards passing as far as my numbers go, but he understands it. He doesn't have to be great. Just manage a football game against a tough defense and let the game come to you, and that's exactly what this quarterback will do.
And so the BC Lions, who have won four of their last five games, will try to even their home record to 3-3 here in the fourth quarter as Brown takes the punt over the fourth quarter. Gets away from the first tackle, reverses field. Tim Brown still going. And Brown, with a fly down, gets right back where he started. We ran a long way to get maybe a yard in the return. That might be wiped out as the flag down on it. And once again, Andre Drew having a conference with his officials. Decide what's going to happen here. BC next week, by the way, home to Toronto next game for them. And a long discussion. This appears to be against the Lions. We've got an injured player as well. Kevin Glenn, by the way, is 18-23 passing that for 224 yards and a touchdown.
Bring your return. Illegal block. DC number 20. That penalty's declined. Also during the return, major foul. Unnecessary roughness. Clipping. DC number 28. Half the distance from the 15-yard line and a first down.
So Jamal Johnson called for the clip. Pascal Lachard is the injured BC Lion. Just slowly now getting to his feet. So all that means that the Lions are going to start this drive at their own 7-yard line. So, Matt, if you're the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, you're only down 10 with a full quarter to play. You do have an inexperienced quarterback, but if you get a stop here from your defense, you'll get some field position, and you're back in the football game.
Absolutely. And it can happen. I mean, Winnipeg's defense shut down Glenn there in the third quarter for a tune of 31 yards passing on 4 of 8 attempts. And it was here in the fourth quarter, give Brian Brom that offense, short field, maybe get a score defensively. We talked about it earlier, 22 defensive touchdowns already this season, 21 all of last season by the defenses. It can happen. We've seen it a lot in 2014.
And from the 7, here's the carry to Stephon Logan, and Logan dives across the 10-yard line. There he is, Abraham Kroma. Filling in for Andrew Kowali, the middle linebacker spot, came up to make the stop.
Yeah, watch this. This is just a bastardized front. He got four guys grouped up, and 51's going to emerge from the pile, basically going to fill in the hole right there. Stephon Logan looked like he shot out of a cannon, hitting that hole with no fear whatsoever.
And there's Kowali looking on, as Karan Lalzer reported earlier. Took a finger in the eye.
I just can't believe that a finger in the eye it's holding him out. I think it's a serious eye injury for that to happen.
Now on second down, Glenn steps away from the pressure. Still coming and throws. Nobody there. And there's the stop the Bombers needed on defense.
Good field position for Brian Brown. The Winnipeg offense coming here. They get a decent return by Studemeyer.
who's lethal in himself. He can make things happen. Love watching that guy in the return game.
Este Hedera is the injured UC line. Kevin Glenn has now thrown four straight incompletions.
This is not good because they've already down with the receiver. SJ and what happened to him. He just run down the field. He just pulls up. It looks like a groin.
Same thing we saw with Courtney Taylor earlier.
It's a groin. A ceiling, a roof is the ceiling. Yeah, right. That roof is open. Pretty warm here on the West Coast. I don't know, 25, 26, beautiful day out in Vancouver. Not evening, but these guys are going down like it's 120 in here.
Schmidt left the punt from his own end zone. Here's a chance, the opening for the Bombers. Four times this year, Matt, Winnipeg has won football games in which it's trailed in the fourth quarter. Yeah, but the man who engineered those comebacks,
yeah, he's on the sidelines.
He's on the sidelines, you're willing.
So Courtney Taylor's already down with the foot problem, ankle problem issue, and now it looks like he's got a groin by Hedera. So everybody's up. Short, so I'll expect them to go double tides. Expect Rolly Lombala being in the offensive team now, and we'll see next time they have the football. But Winnipeg's gonna be a good field position. I want to see what Stockton Schutemeyer can do in return here.
Standing close to midfield, waiting to punt for Ricky Schmidt, who's been pounding it most of the night. From the goal line, good kick by Schmidt. Schutemeyer, though, for the BC 50, fields it cleanly. And Schutemeyer will go out of bounds at the 44, a 37-yard punt. A return of five. And now the focus shifts to the BC defense, led by Saul Elamimian, having another outstanding night in Oregon. Professional grade. Beautiful night here in Vancouver. Across the street for Elton John, who's playing. And under the open roof, the Lions and the Bombers. Winnipeg with the football at the BC 45. Lions fans know the importance of this drive and this defensive stop. And Brom takes it ahead, or if that was drawn up that way. Willie having a look now from the Winnipeg sideline, shaking up in the first half when Kareem Smith took him down hard.
Yeah, they keep doing that. Robert Marr's got to get lathered up in a hurry because he's next up. You don't be running Brom too much. Let him have the big, he'll take shots at him.
Is incomplete. They would have been covered the play by Ryan Phillips.
Yeah, he's getting $1 short of that ball. Need to be out much quicker. I think he had plenty of time.
So now a field goal try and a long one for the Bombers to try to draw within seven.
And he's throwing a corner route to Aaron Kelly. He just didn't get it out there quick enough. Stick it out there. He could have gone high and over the top, but he brought him back. And didn't spot the ball very well.
This is a 49-yard attempt for Hirolahu. And he hits a low drive through. And the Bombers are within a touchdown with 12:07 to go in the fourth quarter. We're back after this. Go to San Francisco to take on the 49ers. Live coverage underway at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, across four of our newly expanded TSN feeds. Seahawks fan in the house. Big win for them in week one. There's the trounce by the Buffalo Bills in their opener. And Lions start on the ground with Stephon Logan. And Logan around the corner picks up four. You might have seen this coming based on who the Lions put out to start this possession, Matt. A lot of people on the field for BC.
Yeah, you've got Cody Husband was out there and Rolly Lambala, and that's a byproduct of already losing Courtney Taylor and S.J. Hedera due to injury. And so they're going with the run, and that's not a bad call based on Winnipeg's defensive pass.
Seven offensive linemen on the field that last play. Now more traditional linemen on second and long. Glenn up and throwing in the pass is complete to Andrew Harris, and Harris thrown down right away by DeMond Washington.
Yeah, they go empty backfield here, run a little hitch screen to 33. Good idea.
Give me the thing, first down BC.
Not having much success in between the tackles, so just get your weapons on the edge and give them the football. That's exactly what Kevin Glenn does. They got five very tight offensive linemen, drawing them close, and then give it to Harris on the edge, gets a block, and Randall's there, Washington's there, but not before he picks up a first down. I like it.
Back to the ground, and Harris again, cuts through the middle, across midfield, down to the Winnipeg 53-yard line. And a gain of 10, close to another BC first down.
This is just playing with your normal five offensive linemen, and Lambala's coming across the edge. Watch what he does. He just comes over here, and he's going to bounce it right through the hole. This is a nice job by... There's Rolly, getting up at a second level, feeling it. A nice play call. Success. We've seen it late against the Winnipeg Blue Bomber defense. A defense that, if you ask anybody in the Bomber organization, says that it's a bend, don't break. They just take care of the penalty side of things. Don't blow up on special teams. We've seen that already in this ball game. They're winning some of those games they've lost recently.
65 yards rushing for the Lions on the night in total, 22 of them from Andrew Harris. 16-9, the score in favor of BC.
Everybody come down here, and then here you see Rowley get up on the second level, and then Harrison's going to pick his way through the other side this time. Wash him down, seal it, and there's a lane right there that Gord Miller can run through.
I'm 49. I'd walk. Here's Logan. He gets spun around after a gain of six. Maurice Leggett with the stop, and a gain of... Call it 5.5.
That's got to be disturbing for Bomber fans to watch this defense giving up big chunks on a very critical drive. This is a situation where, you know what BC's got to do, basically based on the people that are out of the ball game and who they can afford to have on the offensive huddle. Logan bouncing to the outside, picking up big chunks here, 7 yards, putting him in second and 3 men in the situation. It's a big drive. They're only up 7. This is a very close ball game. Bombers are sticking around. Trying to force the wrong field goal.
Now the toss to Harris. He gets straightened up and he crosses the 30-yard line. He'll be probably a yard short of the first down. His drive began at the BC 35-yard line. And he just pounded the ball up the field.
You're going to go with McCallum, who's been money all year. He's got a streak going like crazy. And, or are you going to go with the third and short situation?
And McCallum's streak just came to end to 23 on the last possession. But this is an interesting one, Mac. This is a full yard, maybe a bit more. And you wonder if, at this point, you just take your three.
Yeah.
Well, you do. Well, you always gamble, so I can't ask you. Yeah, remember we told you earlier.
They're going for it, but they're pulling McCallum out.
Yeah,
they're
pulling McCallum out, trying to field goal. The percentage play with 8.5 to go, making a 2-possession game. And this try will count from the 37-yard line. It was only his second miss of the season.
Yeah, he's been on fire. Start a new streak here.
And he's back on the beam, and he's got three important points for the Lions. They're back up by 10, 19-9 to score. Team is winning the game, but Mike, being the Lions are losing some players, he's far involved even more.
Yeah, Gord, this is turning into a real war of attrition. Receiver S.J. Hedera is done for the night with a groin injury. Now, they tried to tape up Courtney Taylor's foot to see if he could return, but no go for him. And Ryan Phillips, the perennial all-star halfback, is out with a hamstring injury. He's not going to return to Corey Williams. Normally, the nickel, the Sam player, is not going to move to the halfback spot for BC for the rest of this half.
Field goal, first down, Winnipeg to the 35-yard line, and Brom is under pressure and down as Khalif Mitchell reached out and got maybe the back of his shoe to make the tackle.
Yeah, technical play by Khalif Mitchell. It's a hustle play, too. Deep drops by the linebackers, and Mitchell's going to bounce out here late and just get the shoestring tackle on Brian Brom, and he's going outside there, redirects, gets his hands up, then dives. Desperation, he makes the play. Well done.
Here comes the run down, second down, the pass complete to Brixby, and Saul Condemian will have none of that.
That's 100, 56 and 44. Getting there at the same time, putting up a brick wall.
Well, that's fun to watch.
That is just good defense, smart defense, second and long. Watch these guys drop. Stoney's going to drop. Biggie's going to drop. He's over here. You can't see him. But you will when the point of attack comes. Ball's chunked down. Here they come. Bam!
That's good. Tim Brown watches the punt go out of bounds. And at about the 35-yard line, a flag comes down.
You will get punished. 100 all day.
Watch out, baby.
44, 56, 100.
Playing with an edge, those two. I guarantee it. I'm the quarterback on the field. That is a block out of bounds. The 10-yard penalty will be enforced at the end of the play. First down.
Do you hear what they're saying?
We catch it, and we'll be punished. Team 100.
What happened?
They're up front. And here's the last play we saw. Dump it down. They know what's going on. Bang. Tag team it. That's sending a message. Two of the back of the league.
Another special team problem with the Bombers. The illegal punt goes out of bounds in the air between the 20s. And so now, BC set up at its 43-yard line. Here comes the running attack again. Andrew Harris. Bounces ahead. Does a good job to drag that pile up close to the 50-yard line.
That is outstanding. Outstanding second third effort there by Andrew Harris.
That is just want to and desire. Again, rolling the ball and drawing into the lineup.
There's just tough sledding right there. Winnipeg trying to get stopped here, getting a two and out.
But you mentioned the importance of that last drive for the Lions. Pick the ball from their 35-yard line down to the Winnipeg 30. Get the 3 points. Now Glenn over the middle for Arsenal. The pass is incomplete.
And Gordy, going back to that last drive, although it only ended up in the field goal on the count, starting a new streak, they had four carries for 36 yards, averaged 9 yards per carry, a very critical time of the football game, getting back to a 10-point lead.
But now, they'll be forced to punt with 5:54 to go. The crowd didn't like Benavides' call. Now, Benavides is going to challenge, pass interference here.
That's about the only thing I can think he might.
Now, we mentioned that the last 14 coaches' challenges have been unsuccessful. That's an 11-game period.
Challenging the ruling on the field of an incomplete pass. He believes that there was a pass interference on the defense.
And pass interference challenges this year have been very ineffective. 32 of them, only 6, have resulted in an overturn.
Yeah, I believe this, you know, this is Manny coming over here. And if you let him play out and...
Bruce Johnson there on the coverage.
I think it's pretty dang good coverage. I don't think you can get much better than that. That kid from Miami playing lights out right now against one of the best receivers in the league, Bruce Johnson. He's a rangy kid against a big receiver, making that look pretty easy. I don't know if Benny's going to get this one, but I think he's feeling the stress and tightness and the closeness of this football game. Being one team 6-5, one 6-4, this is a huge game. It's playoff football. Have big ramifications down the road and where you finish in the West.
There is not enough evidence to change the ruling on the field of an incomplete pass. Ruling in the field stands, incomplete pass, third down.
That's 15 unsuccessful challenges in a row. So the officials are way ahead of the coaches right now.
Well, yeah. There was plenty of evidence that there wasn't interference. That was good. That was a great play by Bruce Johnson.
Good drive to deep to the line from the 12-yard line. Looking for the corner. Here comes Big Hill, and Big Hill makes a great special team play for the BC Lions.
You want to look back to the Canadian Football League, what you do at the linebacker position. And that's not enough for this guy.
That wasn't 100. That was all 44.
Yeah, it was his appetite for the game. It's evident on this play. This is a hustle play. He's already run 50 yards down the field. Then he's got to redirect against one of the fastest, most dangerous returners in the league, Detroit Stoudemire. And he tracks him down.
That's like a lion taking down a gazelle. Hunting him down and got him.
That's a great analogy, Wolf.
Now first down, Bombers from their 15-yard line. The screen pass, but Grigsby's wrapped up, and there's Kareem Smith along with Sheldon Olivier on the tackle. That's going to be a loss of three on the play, maybe four.
Yeah, just read this out. Kareem's way out here. This is what the Lions like to do with their defensive end. Start with plenty of space on the edge and funnel everything to the linebacker. Kareem gets a nice push, comes off the redirects, and there he is. And that's based on Solomon Elamini scraping outside, forcing him back into the inside pursuit. That's well designed defense.
Now Brom up and throwing the pass is incomplete for Corey Watson. And once again, it's third down for the Bombers. The bye week can't come soon enough for Winnipeg. Entering the game with four losses in the last five.
There's a catchable ball, Gord. Spots it right in the hole. Goes right through his hands. That's the play you got to make. Pressure receivers make those plays.
Ira Lahu. The Brown was that bounce in front of him. And the Lions pick it up quickly as doing the punt with Jamal Johnson. It's a 30-yard punt. Winnipeg has gone two and out four straight times. So the wheel's getting wobbly here for Winnipeg. Poor special teams play, some penalties.
Son in the league, watch out. Hey, you're never hanging over.
Yeah, that's one of the best returns in the league.
Yeah. Winnipeg for 27, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Well, yeah, on the play, you talk about the bad punt, but it was a one-hopper back to Liram Hairalua, and you're gonna watch the one-hopper back to him. That's going to throw off your timing.
And we'll go over his head earlier for a safety.
Yeah, he didn't want that to happen for the third time in 2 weeks. Throws off his rhythm.
So here's Harris with a first down carry. And just squirts out of that hole and gets down to the 30-yard line.
Well, he's got a long way to go to get to 250, but these are critical rushing plays here for Andrew Harris.
Gain of seven. And the clock continues to run down close to the three-minute warning.
How do you feel about that, making predictions like that from players?
Namath did it, Messier did it, maybe just leave it at that.
We're talking about Namath and Messier?
Yeah. Just leave it at that.
Okay.
Let them do it.
Yep.
Kevin Glenn does at the ball game.
And Paul McCullough puts the point after up and through, so now a 17-point lead for the Lions. These teams play one more time this year, so Winnipeg won the first meeting 23-6, so a 17-point difference in the first one. The same here tonight.
Yeah, here's Kevin Glenn. He's going to play action. He's going to look left, okay? He's got the big boys up front. Manny's talking about getting the camera on him. But Kevin's looking left. Look at his eyes. Just all going this way, drawing the defense that way. Knowing that he's coming backside, opening up room for veteran receiver Manny Arsenault. And throws a strike. Here's Manny. He didn't have to run. He just basically get on your horse and climb the ladder and get deep. And the ball's there. Well, that's fun. The way they do it in practice, well designed, never a pause, never a doubt. Great picture of the veteran quarterback's eyes. This is what he brings to the table. Snap! Give it to him. How quick it happens. That's from the gun. Point bend and the play action. Snap. Put it on the money. Count it. Ball game.
Thomas Lilley on the sideline. Mike Benavides, the Lions coach, was asked this week about whether or not the Lions breakup hope ended with the injury to Lilley. He took offense to the question and said, that's not fair to Kevin Glenn. Use stronger language than that, but we can't say that. Neudemeyer from the 10. Bounced out of bounds. At the 36-yard line, we've reached the three-minute warning in Vancouver. And Kevin Glenn starts the first 9 games of the year for the BC Lions. He's back in charge for the Orange and Black. Edition of one of the premier grass races on the continent is live for Woodbine Racetrack. Coverage of the Rico Woodbine Mile gets underway at 5:30 p.m. Eastern, 2:30 Pacific on TSN2.
Before this happens. That hurts.
And here it comes again. Second down, and Braun throws that. Manny Arsenault almost had another catch this time on the sideline. That'll bring up third down for Winnipeg. So the focus in Winnipeg will be on Drew Willey's health. And for the 5-week coming, whether or not the shoulder injury he suffered in the first half is serious.
That's unfortunate either way. This team's going to have to find a way to regroup because they're going to drop another one here tonight.
Only 5 losses in the last 6 games for Winnipeg.
And then 1-5 against the Western Division opponent. It's going downhill quickly for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers.
On the other side, the Lions on the verge of winning for the 5th time in the last 6 games.
and the importance of having a number two guy that's capable, like Kevin Glenn, like a Drew Tate, like a Matt Nichols. It's huge.
And by the way, the BC Lions, including tonight, have no turnovers in the last four games. They have not turned the ball over in their last four games, including tonight.
That's clean football. During the return,
holding.
BC number 13, 10-yard penalty, first down. That's how you're able to win game 7-5 or 26-9 at this point. That's the biggest stat. Most all the times you look at the plus-minus situation after ball game, Gordon, that usually tells the tale.
Yeah, you win the turnover battle, you'll win the football game 95% of the time. So the Lions begin at their 30. 2:17 to go. Here's Harris again. This by the first man, Chris Green. Takes a shot for DJ Dunn. There's a gain of 12 and a BC first down.
This is it. This is just pot shot time for the offensive lineman in the running game. Just going to bounce it to the left, just sees it, makes people miss, as good backs do. Getting help on the edge from Keto Cobra. Good team play.
Harris gets free again. Up to the 48-yard line. Gain of 7.
This is your favorite time. The offensive lineman, your big boy, he likes to eat. This is eating time. This is dessert. And he just gets to pile it on here. Come downhill and blow people up. Whole lot of grunting and groaning going on right now, and Andrew Harris is a beneficiary from those big boys doing it up front. I mean, wasn't it 250? But the last several drives in the fourth quarter have been critical for this offensive line against the Winnipeg Blue Bombers defense.
Now here's Stephon Logan. Around the corner, first down, it gets out of bounds. At the 54-yard line, the Blues just did it again, even the clock does stop. Gain of 7 to play. Logan averaging 5.5 yards a carry this year. Of course, it was last season when Logan was brought in midseason that Andrew Harris got moved out of the feature back spot for BC and to share the load.
Yeah, it's I mean, then you can throw a Tim Brown in there if you want to. They've got something going on here.
And now Beck in, gives it off to Logan. We've got John Beck.
And you know, I'll say this about DeMarcus Hardrick, starting left tackle, fifth one for the Lions in the last 11 weeks. They like this kid to bring a sense of toughness to the offensive line. First-year player from Nebraska. You know what they do down there. They turn it out. And they like what they see in this guy. And he's done a nice job tonight protecting Kevin Glenn and blending in quite nicely.
They do preacher curls and run the football in Nebraska.
I didn't know about preacher curls.
Oh, look out.
Uh-oh, he blew a tire.
But look at this.
Oh, man.
He was running good for that. He was.
Like that, you can't be doing this. Sniper gets him right here. Whoop! You got to get up. Find that hole. There's one right there. Shows you his speed. Oh, my goodness. Things are falling your way. That looked like he was on ice. You heard like Bambi.
Here's those guys. They waited to set it up. And now here's Logan in down to the 30-yard line. This drive began with 2:17 to go in the fourth quarter, and the BC Lions just squeezing the life out of the rest of this football game.
Yeah, this is dessert time for those big boys. And this is fun. All their hard work pays off. All that eating, lifting. We talked about the discrepancy between weight up front. Doesn't get any easier for the Bombers' defensive line with these big boys coming downhill.
Here's Harris back in. Passes outside. Fights halfway down to the 21-yard line, and it's another BC first down.
A smart play by Andrew standing bound. He can turn it up, but he can force it out of bounds. Drop the stop, but he wants to stay in bounds.
It's 160 yards of the ground for the Lions tonight.
That's about 40 over what Winnipeg gives up. They give up 125 a game, and that's going to go up again. Because what's happened here in the fourth quarter, when they needed to control the line of scrimmage and fill the clock and establish a little bit of field position to get a 10-point lead, when only up by seven, they made that happen. And then it's more of the same here the last couple of drives.
The line is down right near the end of the play here. So Kevin Glenn, who started the first nine games of the season.
Time down violation, BC number 12. This is a loss of down, second down.
Gives way to John Beck. But Glenn, in his 14th CFL season, has more wins as a starter over the last 4 years than any other CFL quarterback. One thing remains out there for him.
What's that?
The breakup.
Absolutely, and it's here at the house. What a fitting way to get it, being the fourth quarterback in a row to host and win a Grey Cup with your football team. Kevin Glenn has put himself in a situation where that is feasible.
The Lions now on fire the last